There are several reasons to consume amla or Indian gooseberries because it's packed with vitamin C and antioxidants. It's very good to improve or boost your immunity. But some of us need to be careful. Without any further delay, let's discuss who all cannot consume this particular citrus fruit and why. Or can it be consumed in moderation? Let's discuss. Hi, my name is Jesley and you're watching Jessopedia. The first category of people who need to be careful is people suffering from hyperacidity or heartburn. Amla is rich in vitamin C, so it's very good for digestive health. But if you are sensitive to acidic food, then you need to be careful. Why I'm telling you is that normally amla is prescribed to be taken in empty stomach. So taking acidic food in empty stomach can worsen your symptoms and can irritate the inner lining of your stomach. So it may not be a very good idea to consume too much of amla or amla juice if you have heartburn symptoms or if you are having hyperacidity. So it's better to avoid amla if you are having the symptoms or if you are very sensitive to acidic food. The next category of people who need to be more careful is people suffering from low blood pressure or hypotension. Actually, amla is consumed by people who have high BP or high blood pressure. So if you are already having low blood pressure and you are taking medicines or medications for low blood pressure, and on top of that you are consuming amla, it can bring your BP further down. So you need to be careful. At least when you are having low blood pressure, please avoid eating amla. The next category of people who need to be more careful while consuming amla is people with blood-related disorders. Amla has antiplatelet properties. In simple terms, it can thin your blood. So, amla is normally consumed by people with high cholesterol. It can thin your blood or it can bring your cholesterol levels a little bit low. So, if you're already having low platelet level or any blood-related disorders, it may be advisable to consult your doctor before consuming amla or before consuming too much of amla. Another situation where you need to be very careful regarding amlas is if you have to undergo a surgery. It's better to avoid amla before or after a surgery. The same reason, that is, amla has antiplatelet effect. So please do consult your doctor regarding the same. Another category of people who need to avoid eating too much of raw amla or amla juice is people with hypoglycemia or people with very low blood sugar. Amla is consumed by people with high blood sugar. So if you're already having low blood sugar and you are having medications for the same reason, and on top of that you are consuming too much of amla, there can be an issue. It can result in hypoglycemia. So one thing is that you have to discuss with your doctor, or you have to monitor your blood sugar on a regular basis. So you have to avoid amla on that particular days where your blood sugar is really low. Next category is people with dry skin and scalp. Actually, amla is very good for your skin and your hair, but it has diuretic properties. That means it can result in dehydration. So if you're not drinking water and if you're not consuming enough fruits and vegetables, and on top of that you're consuming too much of raw amla or juice, it can result in dehydration or it can aggravate your dry skin symptoms. So drink plenty of water and consume enough fruits and vegetables and reap the benefits of amla. Next category is pregnant ladies or breastfeeding mothers. Actually, eating one or two amlas in the form of pickle or candy is good, but if it is irritating your stomach or if it is resulting in diarrhea or constipation, please do avoid that. Next is while you are having runny nose or cold symptoms. Actually, amla is very good for boosting your immunity or fighting cold and cough. But if you are having the symptoms, it is better to avoid eating amla because amla is a natural coolant, so it can aggravate your symptoms. The next category of people who need to be more careful is people with liver disease. Liver disease or liver failure can be accompanied with low platelet levels. So if you're already having low platelet levels and you're consuming too much of amla, it can be an issue. So please do consult your doctor before consuming amla in the raw form or in the form of a juice or anything. Next category of people who need to be very careful regarding consuming too much of amla fruit or juice as people on certain medications. If you are having antiplatelet drugs or diabetic medicines or anticoagulants, you need to be very careful. Please consult your doctor before consuming anything like this. Otherwise also, it's not that safe to consume Ayurvedic preparations along with your allopathic medicines or certain type of medicines. So always consult your doctor or always discuss with your doctor. All the adverse effects mentioned here may not be that serious, but it can definitely cause some discomfort. So the game here is eat amla in moderation. You can have one or two amlas every day in the form of a pickle or candy. It is very good, especially during winters. It is a winter superfood. It can provide you with vitamin C, antioxidants, and it can boost our immunity. So please don't fall for the marketing gimmicks like shots or pills or decoctions. Have amla as a part of our diet. Anything in excess is not good, even if it is our amla or Indian gooseberries. Thank you so much for watching. Don't forget to smile and don't forget to love yourself.